Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. The coronavirus has taken over the news, social media, and most of our conversations. The stats are changing every day, and we've seen cities like Los Angeles and New York declaring a state of emergency. But oftentimes, the best defense against disease can be information. Mm-hmm. Today, one of our favorite physicians is here to break it all down for us. Please welcome Dr. Frieda. Good to have you back.
It's great to be back.
Yes. Dr. Frieda, you'd be so shocked.
Yes.
Thank you. Time you come down to the circle, girl. Okay, let's get into it. Mm-hmm. Everybody, it's this whole craze of, I'm down to the airport, child. And it's masks. I was in the airport, and there's a woman in the first class with me. She has a mask on. She come up to me afterwards. No, we were standing next to each other outside, and she comes up to me afterwards, and she says, she starts talking. Hey, Selena, how's it going, girl? I said, my God, today, that's Monica. Child, the virus got us so jammed up, we don't even know each other no more. She said, child, I'm just trying to protect myself from the people. She said, I know it's hard to get it. But what is the real tea with this coronavirus? And is it as bad as the flu? Like, give us the tea, because the people are going insane out here.
Well, here is the tea. The mask, a standard mask, actually won't protect you from getting the coronavirus in most cases.
People just want to wear the mask.
It's a one-time use mask. If it gets wet, if it gets saliva, it's no good. And the coronavirus can be so small that it can get around the mask, through the mask. When you fiddle with the mask with your hands, you're increasing your chances. So you can protect other people from getting your germs, but not yourself. Wow. We call it the novel coronavirus, but really,
it's not.
Coronaviruses were discovered back in the 1950s.
Yes. Mm.
They were. And they call them coronaviruses because if you look at them under a microscope, the envelope, the surface, has these points like a crown or a corona, coronavirus. And there are many subtypes. We have the human common coronavirus, the common human coronaviruses, which just give you illnesses like the common cold, and most people have been exposed. But then we have the more serious coronaviruses like MERS or Middle East Respiratory Syndrome or SARS. And now, of course, the novel coronavirus or the COVID-19. Mm-hmm. It is serious. We should be prepared, but we should not panic.
Yes. How do you prepare, though? Like, can we protect ourselves? Can we really protect ourselves then?
Number one, you stay well informed. And you try to protect yourself by good hand hygiene. Make sure you wash your hands. Use hand sanitizer. Instead of shaking hands, give them a good elbow.
Yes.
Just throw
good
the bow.
To you.
That's what you do. And if you, that's
good
it.
You.
That's it.
Mm-hmm.
And also, if you cough, use your elbow, use a tissue, and if you use a tissue, please throw it away.
And then wash your hands afterwards.
And wash your hands afterwards.
Yes.
And try not to touch handrails if you don't have to.
Yeah, I don't.
If someone sneezes and touches an elevator button and you touch that and touch your face, that's not good.
Right.
Use your knuckles.
Yeah, that's what I did yesterday.
Oh, your nail.
So what are some of the signs and symptoms of coronavirus? How can we identify that this might be something that we're challenged with?
The thing about the coronavirus is that the signs and symptoms can be very common to the flu, to the common cold. You can get fever, shortness of breath, you can get a cough, and it can be mild to moderate, or it can be severe, where you get respiratory failure, you have severe lung disease. If you have any of these symptoms and you think you may have been exposed to coronavirus, you just contact your healthcare provider, and it's a test that you'll have to be sure if you have the coronavirus.
See, now, I don't think I was as afraid, but now when you say that the masks don't even work, that's posing a slight issue and a problem for me. But because at first, the corona was, it was a mystery pneumonia.
Yes.
And then scientists thought it was spread from animals to humans
and blah, blah, blah.
How was it transmitted?
Excellent question. And the data does keep changing from minute to minute, practically.
See.
So initially, we did think it was from animals to humans only. And we still think that it started off being transmitted from animals to humans. But now we know that you have human-to-human spread through respiratory droplets. And so if someone sneezes and they have the coronavirus, those respiratory droplets, that mucus, that saliva, if you breathe it in, then you can be infected.
So breathing
I can't live my life this way. And see, if you sneeze and achoo, and we're knobbing knobs like that, that means it's on my elbow and my face.
But
and if I sneeze, I'm getting it.
You're less likely to touch your face with your elbow than with your hands. So I still think the elbow bumping is better than hands. But maybe a good wave.
Yeah, just holler. Let's just give a salute and go on about your business.
Go to TI.
Oh my God. Again with, okay, What if you don't know that you have it? Because when you immediately get those symptoms, they might be slight. You know, if you get a cold, it kind of take a while to like manifest into a full-blown cold. So what if you don't know that you have it? Can you pass it?
Absolutely.
Oh my God.
You can get the coronavirus, be infected, and walk around for up to 14 days without showing any symptoms.
That is horrible.
That's 2 weeks.
So you can still be contagious, pass it on, even with no symptoms.
And Dr. Freddie, we've seen a lot of people be quarantined.
Yes.
And so how are they determining the time in which a person will be quarantined?
That's
is it 1 week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, a month? What is it?
We base the quarantine time on the incubation period, meaning the time it takes from exposure to the virus to getting symptoms. For the COVID-19 or novel coronavirus, it's anywhere between 1 day and 14 days. Mm-hmm. So if you become infected, you could have symptoms in 1 day, or you can have symptoms that don't develop until 14 days. And so we quarantine for 14 days from the time of exposure.
Has it been a case where you show symptoms after the 14-day mark?
Not that we have documented, but again, the data keeps changing.
It could be different today.
It could be different in a minute.
Is there a treatment?
And then what are the tips, real quick?
Okay, good
treatment
question.
Treatment and tips.
There's no public treatment available, but there are treatments that have been developed and their trials being done.
Not
Remdesivir in particular, but their trial is not ready. Tips, still, the good hand washing, social distancing, and just being smart and keeping yourself updated, informed. Don't panic.
This is super scary.
Right. Don't panic, prepare. I'm still traveling. God, just bless my soul and everybody
around.
That's
all you can do is pray and keep up your music.
That's right.
My God.
Thank you so much. We always love having you here. Be sure to follow her on Instagram at Dr. Dot Frida. Up next.